Hello, you wonderful people, and welcome to another episode of Super Fantify. This being a show, I talk about TV shows of the supernatural, fantasy, and or science fictional genre. For today's episode, I'm going to talk about the latest episode of His Dark Materials. A lot of really interesting things went down in this episode, so let's break it down. Well, first and foremost, you have so many moving pieces, all taking place in the same world, which I love that, everything is kind of converging in this one world, and I like that. Because, obviously, let's start off with the whole situation with Miss Coulter and Boreal. Obviously, he's the one kind of shaking in his boots because she's like, you're fine. You came through this world before. He was like, yeah, but I was running scared. So I ran away. That's how I ended up surviving. So obviously, there's no, other than the knife, there's no real protection against the specters. But then obviously, and it just seemed like she's so casual about the situation. And then it's like, well, I guess maybe because she doesn't know what they can fully do. That's why she's not too worried about it. But they come across someone. And obviously, you know, Boreal kind of describes it as like they basically sever the... He's like, we don't really know what they do to the humans, but it's like they sever their soul. But then she was like, it actually does something much more, almost like it does... It's something deeper that they do. And she's saying we could learn from it, which I'm like... She's looking at this almost like from a scientific standpoint, because I'm like, I guess for her, maybe because in the last episode, it kind of seemed like she was hinting that, like, basically, you understand something, you have control over it. So if she understands how the specters work, that means she could control them, is what I was basically getting last episode. And this episode kind of confirms that, but we'll get to that in a second. But it was just, I guess, but the way she was talking about, like, oh, we can learn from this. I don't know whether she was just talking about in that regard, but I took it as like her experiments, the whole separating, you know, cutting that link between a person's kids and their demons, right? So I was like, maybe for her, this specter situation could take you even deeper into what, you know. I mean, it also makes you wonder, like, because I didn't realize this until they had pointed it out, that... Lyra's the one that actually pointed it out. That guillotine that they use is made from the same material as the subtle knife. So, I mean, maybe that's why the subtle knife can work on specters. Maybe because it works in that same vein. Regardless, getting back to the whole point is... When the time comes and all the specters are around her, what was interesting is she made her demon stay behind and was like, we still don't... Like I said, stuff is hinting that what she does is very witch-like, but she isn't a witch. So there's definitely something else going on there. But, like, she makes her demon stay behind. And when she can, confronts this, specters, it's almost like at her touch, it was almost like they were trying to avoid her. Because they were just... And can we know how they react to, like, you know, because home dude who had the soto knife beforehand, the old man, who was the previous bearer... He died and they didn't bother with him because, like, whatever makes you human, your soul or whatever it is they take from you when they consume you, it was already gone. His life had left him, his soul or whatever it is. So the moment that happened, they lost interest in him. So it's like whatever she was able to do, she says she's able to suppress herself. So because they swallow your soul or whatever. So it's like she was like basically what makes you human. So she was able to like push that down. So it's like, what are you then? Because you do things kind of similar to a witch, but you don't do other witch things, which kind of confuses me. So that's what I'm curious, like, what her situation is. Because it also seems like she does a lot of stuff to kind of... I mean, I guess maybe she applied those experiments and applied them to herself. Because, like, obviously she was able to sever the connection between the demon and a human. And that's like there's a connection on a soul level. That's why when your demon dies, you die. And when you die, your demon dies. But, the fact is that, like, that connection, I guess she took that and applied that to herself and was able to kind of... But it's like, how do you know... I guess... Because I guess she learned how to do that on such a level... I don't know. Like, there's still so many mysteries about Miss Coulter, about how she's able to do what she does. So it's like... But whatever the case may be, she was able to get control of them. Which even Boreal was like, oh, that's really impressive. And now it's like, yeah, now I can find Lyra. You can get that boy you want. And it's like, yeah, but the knife isn't just for me. It's for us. Because we don't even know fully what... No one really knows what the soto knife is capable of, fully capable of. So it's like, we could go anywhere. And she's like, oh, so... Because he was like, I need someone by... This is something where I need someone by my side as an equal. And he looked at her and grabs her hand. And she's like, so I'm your equal. And he was like, yes. And like the moment he said that, I was like... I expected her to straight out say, like, no, we're not equal. I'm far above you. She kind of says that later on, but I kind of expected her to straight out say that at that moment. But I was like, oh, this isn't good. Especially because her snake, his demon was out near hers. I was like, her demon's about to snap his demon's neck or something and kill him. But it's like, nope, she poisoned him. Because for her, it's like, your ambitions have always been too small. And it would have continued to be small. She's like, because the fact of the matter is, you should have told me when you found Lyra immediately, but you didn't. Because he did what he did, because he only did it because it was an advantageous situation for himself. But it's like, you are not, you're saying I'm your equal? No, you're not my equal. The fact of the matter is, you could never basically measure up to me. I was like, jeez. And it's like, yeah, cut the man down while you're slowly killing him. That's hard. Because, like there is some, obviously you can tell he cares about her, so. But for her, it's like, no, you would have just, literally, you would have held me back. So, it's okay, just give in to it, and he dies. I was like, wow. But also, there's that thing later on where she's holding her hand over the fire, and her demon's looking at her. Because, obviously, we saw it last episode that, like, obviously, she can kind of separate herself. We saw that when Lyra, like, you know, Pan was attacking her demon, that she was able to fight through it. And I think it's like, she uses pain as a weapon. So it's like, she wants to like be, she like, I think hurts herself in that regard so that nothing, like it, for her, it's like strength kind of stands above all else. So it's like, you know, she wants to be strong and she's not gonna, she needs that pain, I guess, as a reminder. It's like, if I can suffer through this, I can do anything. I'm strong. Like, I think it's a strength of will, you know? So, and it's like the way she was talking to her demon, like, almost reminding it, like, oh, like, this is where this, because, like, once again, we saw that her demon was getting hurt, but, like, she was able to kind of pull herself away from the pain once again. So, like, I don't know what to really, you know, how to really explain that situation. It's still fascinating. I'm curious to really, like, fully encapsulate that whole thing. I don't know if we'll ever really, they'll really ever dive into, like, I'd assume that'd come up sooner or later, like, fully what her situation and circumstances are, but, you know, we'll have to wait and see, potentially. Another interesting element to kind of talk about is the Magisterium, because you had the whole situation with, obviously, the Cardinal trying to decide what they're going to do, and obviously, the father who reads the Alethiometer was like, okay, I got to tell you something. It's like, okay, Miss Coulter went after her daughter who went into another world, and it's like, her daughter uses Lyra's other name, but then it was like, it's like, yeah, but she has another name, too. And it's like, what's this name? And I love that him being afraid, because it's like, yeah, me saying this stuff is on very, like, on some very heretic-level stuff. But he's like, no, you telling me what something, the Alethiometer told you this, you just telling me something that someone else told you doesn't, you know, make you the heretic in that regard. But basically, he breaks it down that basically he compares Lyra to Eve, saying that basically the mother who basically created all sins and stuff like that. So I was like, okay. I was like, so that's interesting. So you're going as far. And what I thought was interesting, they called her mother, but they never referred to her as Eve. Because then they were basically, he was talking about like Lyra basically being kind of the downfall of them. Like, obviously, there's talk of her great destiny. But beyond that, we don't know we know that it's supposed to represent like freedom and stuff like that. And then they never say what Lyra's real name is. And part of me was like, are we going to find out that Lyra's actual name is like... My immediate thought was at first, I was like, I thought Lilith. I mean, because obviously with the demons and stuff like that, it makes me think that. But it's like, well, because I, you know, I'm not well versed in biblical stuff. I only know bits and pieces here and there just because of what I picked up from, you know, TV shows that have covered it. But I was like, is she supposed to be Lilith? Is that what that whole thing's supposed to be? Or are we trying to say that she is Eve? Could it, because it's like, because that's what, you know, has the Cardinal worried, because it's like, we've only ever seen something like this in history once, and that was with their, like I said, I don't know, because they never said her name, so I don't know if they're saying like the mother that they were referring to is Eve, or does she have a different name in this universe and Lyra is Eve? That's what I'm curious about. Or rather, you know, in this, if not, at the very least, she's the second coming of Eve, if Eve already exists in this universe. But that's why I was wondering, like, you know, just picking up different names. I know, I was like, is she supposed to be like Lilith? I mean, I was almost, I guess you, I don't know if they'd go down that route, because I was about to start thinking like, because that'd be Greek mythology, if I was about to say if they were going to call her Pandora. So I would assume, since we're in a biblical thing, I would assume it's like Lilith, because the whole thing about her is supposed to be, she's supposed to be able to give people freedom, because the Magisterium is the one that's kind of in control, and it's about her destiny is basically destroying that to make it so that people can be free, be who they are, live the life they want to without the Magisterium kind of being in control of everything. And that's kind of, and at its basis, it seems like that's what Lyra's whole deal is supposed to be. So obviously, you know, they're using this as like a holy mission. There's going to have to be sacrifices, and the first sacrifice is going to be Lyra, which I'm sure it's a big, a huge old sin, killing a kid, but, which obviously that's a, sadly, that's, obviously that's happened with everything Coulter did, all her work, plus Azrael did it too, you know, so kind of a recurrent, sadly a recurring theme in this. But aside from all of that, kind of a big focus obviously will be, or well, for one, we find Mary here. She's wondering about, obviously trying to translate some stuff to be like, okay, so what am I supposed to do? Obviously, she's trying to find Lyra. But prior to that, Will's getting worse because I guess like the infection is spreading. At first, that's what it seems like, but it's like we find out that, I mean, it makes sense. The subtle knife can cut through, well, one edge can cut through anything. So I guess it cut through. It's kind of like, God, someone else has a situation like that. I'm trying to think. Oh, it's kind of a weird example to use if Luke Cage. There was a certain bullet that pierced him, and as long as the bullet was inside of him, he couldn't heal. I think, there's been other examples of stuff like that, where it's like, you stop the regenerative process, the natural body's regenerative process was stopped, because I think the wound never stops bleeding, because the wound won't close, because it's a magical wound, and it keeps it open, so he keeps bleeding, and so, I guess the infection is kind of spreading, or, you know, it's killing him, you know, so. But he's also getting visions, and obviously some of that's related to his dad. At the same time, like, obviously the kids all gather up and are planning to kill Lyra and Will, which is like, man, that's savage and messed up. Luckily, Serafina and Serafina in particular intervenes and saves them, basically gets the kids to leave. Because it's a sad thing. It's like a circumstance. They, you know, they didn't create the situation. It's just like they wandered into the tower because they were forced, you know. I mean, if anything, this is Boreal's fault. But at the same time, it's like he took, he took the subtle knife from someone that wasn't hit. And that's why I was like, I guess that's how they stayed safe. Well, I guess he was keeping the knife long enough so he could protect himself while being in a tower. But if the time ever came that the others grew up, because the way it was, Angelica was kind of talking about it, like, it's protecting the people on the hill too. Because I guess it's like, as long as the subtle knife was in his hand, he could also, you know, eventually protect the adults who ran away. I wasn't really 100% clear on what she was getting. I mean, granted, I was thinking maybe she was implying mainly like, if we ever got older, he'd be able to protect us. But for now, he's the only one that's really in danger, him being, you know, reached adulthood and whatnot. But obviously, you know, their intent on getting him back for that. And it's a sad situation that no one wanted, but it turned out this way, and like, you're going to kill them for it, you know? Which obviously Mary runs into kids later on because they're astonished because it's like, the specters aren't coming after. I guess the angels are protecting, which we saw that too. It's like Ruta and Serafina and the other witches were looking, and it's like, those are the angels, but they haven't shown themselves for a thousand years. So it's like, why now? It's like, apparently they joined forces with Azrael. I guess that's why they were like, we're not going to show ourselves in this world because we're going off to meet with Azrael. Why they're necessary? Well, because they said that this is about revenge, and I guess like they want revenge against like the Magisterium and everything that they stand for, maybe the authority that they represent, in the sense that obviously the higher kind of like God or whatever they want to refer, they simply refer to it as the authority, but that entity, maybe it's revenge against them, which immediately my brain was like, are we dealing with like fallen angels, like some Lucifer shit? Like, that's what I'm curious about. Like, is that what the angels, are they actually angels or are they fallen angels? They could be like angels from season 8 of Supernatural. Like, well, you know, spoilers for Supernatural. Like, obviously all the angels from heaven fell and landed on Earth. So maybe it's a kind of a similar, I don't know. But obviously like Azrael, I guess in a sense you could almost look at Azrael as kind of the Lucifer of the situation, kind of being rebelling against authority. You know, that's kind of Lucifer's whole thing. He was the son that rebelled and everything. So, you know, maybe that's kind of the connection you're making. Maybe I'm reading too much into it. But Ruta ends up going after them to kind of find Azrael to kind of bring him back. So, and obviously, Will isn't as trusting to Seraphina as Lyra is. I mean, obviously, Lyra has a connection because home dude from the Egyptians, him and Seraphina, obviously, they had a kid, they had a relationship, and obviously, after their child had passed, like, their relationship fell apart. But I think it's because of that, she's a little more trusting to Seraphina. Obviously, Will's not as trusting to people, and that kind of comes up a little bit later on why that is, but we'll get to that soon enough. Like, so for him, he doesn't want to tell her anything about the Soto knife. Lyra kind of tells her a little bit. That basically can cut through anything, but I don't think she really explains that it, the other side of it being like it can cut through worlds. I don't think she never explains it within the episode, but who knows if like in between stuff she had explained that or not. But Will's situation is getting worse, and it's like the medicine, the herbs that they would use to heal him would be in their world. They'd have to go back to their world because for Seraphina, it's like, it's a place I know well enough that I can keep you hidden, because if we stay here or go to anywhere else I'm not familiar with, I won't know where to hide you. Like, so we might as well go to a place where we have the home court advantage, which obviously that's complicated considering the Magisterium, you know, attacked the witches, and now also they've got a target on Lyra's back as well. But it's an interesting situation. There's a conversation between Will and Lyra. Well, really quickly, Seraphina's so, she's curious like why Lyra's kind of going so above and beyond when it came to Will. And it's for her, it's like because she lost the alethiometer and because she didn't want to use it after what happened to Roger. But now, you know, she realizes how important it is, how connected she is to it. And for her, she wants to do this for Will. She feels like, you know, it's her responsibility. And Seraphina ends up bringing it up to Will, like, about this great destiny that Lyra has. And it's like, you'll need to protect her. You know, she feels like you're her responsibility, but you're hers as well. So you need to protect her. So never forget that, you know. And obviously, that's kind of the whole point of it, too. Like, obviously, the knife bearer, as, you know, John Perry says, like, oh, it's the knife bearer will not just protect Lyra, but protect all of us. You know, it's there's also that situation where it's, you know, Lee and John, and he's asking John, like, you're a shaman and everything, so make some stuff happen. But for him, it's like, no, I've studied magic, I've studied this, but it's like, I'm, at the end of the day, I'm just a human. But it's like, you're able to concoct some stuff that I'm like, I guess he can, he's still a human at the end of the day. He's not a witch, but he can manipulate stuff to be, because it's like, I can even, he's like, because I thought, you know, being a shaman, Lee was like, I thought you could fly, and he was like, I can fly, look at me right now, I brought you to me, and lo and behold, I'm flying right now. So it's like, the technicalities of it, but obviously, there is some mysticism there, in many different regards. Him talking about the fact that he hasn't been back to his world since he left his own world all those years ago, hoping to find a window so that he could get back home, because he thinks about, you know, obviously his wife and his son. And it's like being in his world, he's like, makes me feel closer, which is interesting because obviously that information's there, because it's like, well, John feels like he's closer to Will because he's like, well, I'm close to my world. That's kind of what he's thinking. But obviously, Will knows that his dad's somewhere in this world because the alethiometer said so. And it even tells her, just keep, it was like, it's like, oh, it just says, keep going up. So I actually had expected Seraphina to actually fly into the sky and potentially see the hot air balloon, but that ended up not being the case. But obviously, it's a situation of they eventually find out, hey, there's Magisterium behind us, and it's like, we need to escape. And you have John being so calm about the whole situation. It's like, we're flying into a storm. He's like, can you, like, summon some guns or something? And it's like, the storm, lightning strikes and destroys one ship. Then, like, he summons a whole bunch of, a flock of birds to take down another. And it's like, the third one's turned away. Hey, they shoot down the, they shoot, one of the bullets lands and just messes up something, so obviously the whole thing is coming crashing down, so, but hey, it puts them in an area where I think brings them a little closer to Lyra and Will, but I mean, maybe that's the whole point, like, everything kind of happens for a reason, right? And speaking of Lyra and Will, Will does kind of open up to Lyra a little bit about why he, like, because for her, she's trying to understand, like, how kids could be as, you know, vicious and mad. Like, because she's like, I don't think Angelica and them were as bad as we think they are, because it's, you know, obviously their circumstances led them to that situation, which I didn't talk about it, but Mary went off with them to kind of, you know, take them to the hill where the adults are, because it's like she's the only one that's not affected the specters once again don't affect her. So I'm like, is it because the angels are protecting her? Because obviously, like, the way it gets explained, it's like the way John explains it, it's because obviously kids aren't attracted to dust, and so because adults are, like, that's what draws specters to them and stuff like that. So part of me is like, is it because she's from a different world, so the specter situation doesn't necessarily affect her the same way, because they're from a world where dust... Well, no, because I don't know if dust is really a thing in this world they're in right now. So it might not matter what world you're in. It must simply be like the angels are protecting her. Or maybe her interactions with them kind of rub something... Like, maybe her speaking to the dust kind of rubs something off on her that, like, they just won't mess with. So I mean, maybe there's kind of supposed to be something similar between, like, what is happening with Mary and what's happening with Miss Coulter's situation. Maybe there's supposed to be similarities, you know, that can be drawn by why neither one of them is affected. Maybe under the right circumstances, maybe even Mary could control. I'm probably reading too much into it. Maybe she can't nearly take it as far as Miss Coulter could, but regardless, circling back to it, Will talks about the fact is that he knows that kids can be just as assholish, even crueler than Angelica and them, because he brings up his situation at home, because his mom, it's like, she kind of does things that aren't really normal, and because it kind of seemed like she kind of has some, like, you know, some stuff, like, it seemed like there might be, like, some, God, what's the word I'm thinking of? I kind of labeled it as kind of a little bit of OCD last season, like, because he said, like, she has to, like, count the bricks and stuff like that, like, her mind can't concentrate unless she does certain things, like, you know, the whole thing, like, you might have to, like, turn a doorknob like 3 times. Like, obviously that's like the more like extreme end of like OCD. But it's like you have to repeat a certain thing a number of times before your mind can like focus, before you can do anything. Maybe it's something like that. But obviously, like, kids can be cruel and stuff like that. And so for him, he had, you know, since he was young, he'd always thought like he'd find out where his dad was and bring his dad back, and his dad would have all the answers. But as he got older, he stopped believing that. And because of that, you know, dealing with that, you know, at school, the situation with his mom, not having his dad there, kind of giving up on his dad ever coming back and having all the answers, he kind of just stopped trusting people because he kind of saw the worst side of people. And I guess he just assumed a lot of people were like that. So it wasn't easy for him to trust people. And Lyra being like, until you met me, right? And he was like, yeah, you know, so I like that. So I think it's like, regardless of anything, I trust you, Lyra, and you can trust me. You know, kind of, I think taking Serafina's words to heart, being like, whatever you got to go through, you're helping me find my dad, I'm going to help you too. So, interesting development on that front. Obviously, they're going through the woods and the specters attack. Luckily, Will's got the knife, so he's able to push them back. But it can fend them off. But, because I don't know if they said it could straight up... I think I've been under the impression it can kill the specters. I would assume so, because it can cut through anything. But I think it just said that it fends them off. It never said that it can kill. I don't remember. I think they did say it can kill specters. That's what I'm trying to figure out. Did it actually say that, or am I just pulling that, you know, out of thin air and just kind of made it out? Did I just make that assumption on my own? Regardless, very interesting circumstances everyone's found themselves in. I'm curious to see where everything and everyone ends up going forward into the next episode. But really, that's all I want to talk about. Until the next time we meet, be happy, be safe, love life to the fullest, and enjoy it. Good day and goodbye.